All right, listen up, everybody. The bus will be leaving at 7 a.m. sharp tomorrow, so be on time. Otherwise...
Whoa. Sorry, prom queen.
Hey, you two, find a seat. Let's go. I expect it from Mr. McMullen, but I'd hope better from you, Emma.
Sorry, Mr. Christensen.
All right. So, tomorrow, the bus will be leaving at 7 a.m. sharp. All right, be on time, or the bus will be leaving without you.
Coming on, boy, get on this trip
is a privilege,
Daddy
not a right.
I
expect you all to behave like adults.
You know I can hear you, right?
Time. So for the first 5 days in Trinidad, we'll be helping to renovate a school with Project for Humanity.
The last 3 days, we'll be exploring the island and going on cultural excursions throughout the country, and it should be a lot of fun.
And welcome, everybody, to the Cast Presents here in Buffalo in Western New York. You know, basically, we love going to Hollywood, and we do it every chance we can. And today, we get to do it with a great guy. He's a co-star of The Blue Lagoon, the 1980s blockbuster film with Brooke Shields. You got to know him. He's that handsome, curly-haired young man who you always saw with his shirt off kind of thing. We have with us Christopher Atkins. Christopher, welcome to the Cast Presents.
Hey, Don. It's nice to be here in Buffalo this morning.
Now, do you still have that curly hair ever? I mean, when your hair gets wet, does it curl, or what's the deal?
I always had straight hair. The director always saw this Greek Adonis guy, so they permed my hair like it seemed like every other week on that island that we shot that movie on, just to have curly hair. I do not have curly hair.
Funny you should say Greek Adonis. That's how all the women describe you here in the studio.
Okay, that's very nice. Thank you very much.
Now, listen, must be a burden being a sex symbol. I know because I've read a lot about it.
From what I hear, you're one too. Is that true?
No. I was just setting myself up for
yeah.
it. And I deserved it. I deserved it. But listen, the new movie coming out on June 16th at 8 p.m. on Lifetime is entitled Blue Lagoon, The Awakening.
Yes.
Tell me about your part in it and what similarities we might see with The Blue Lagoon.
Well, there's a lot of similarities in the story. The differences are that, you know, the one that I did, we were little kids that were marooned back in the 1800s, and this version is high school kids in modern day. I play one of the teachers that we go and do a Habitats for Humanity and take a bunch of students to Trinidad, and the students all go out to party one night, you know, without us knowing, and they kind of get in trouble, and it's out on a boat, and the next thing you know is one falls overboard, another goes to save her. They end up in a dinghy and separated from the rest of the group as the police are taking them in, and before you know it, they're caught in currents and the whole thing, and the next thing, they're on the island, and they think they're only there for a little bit with all the modern technologies with cell phones and lighters and all of that. But it's still very interesting because it, you know, as that wears off and nobody shows up, now you're talking about survival, and then once you get past the survival, it's the two people, and then it's life and death, and it's that Romeo Juliet type of movie, and I think that's what makes the movie so timeless. It's that swept away Romeo Juliet, you know, sort of love story, a girl who is an overachiever, a guy who's a slacker in high school, and they meet, they're forced together on this island, polar opposites, and they have to learn to work together. They have to learn to survive, and through that, their shields come down, and their true inner self comes out, and they actually, you know, let those feelings evolve, and that's the awakening.
You know, I see you're also starring with Denise Richards.
Yes, Denise Richards is in it. Yes, that's
she's,
right.
She's
she was
awesome.
Great.
You tell her I said hi. Don from Buffalo, okay?
Don says hi. I certainly will.
Pass it along. Thank you. Okay. Now, you know, here's the thing, too. A lot's gone on since The Blue Lagoon, okay? What's this like getting involved in another Blue Lagoon-type movie so many years later? You're mature. You've accomplished so much in your life, and you have new interests, and you're not that young kid anymore. What was it like? Did it bring back, you know, feelings? And talk to me about that a little bit.
Well, yeah, it brought back a lot of feelings because that movie was not just a movie; it was a life experience. I mean, literally, when I made the Blue Lagoon, it was on a deserted island in the middle of the Yasawa chain in Fiji. I mean, there was nothing there. I literally lived in a tent, shooting that picture for 4.5 months. So. rereading this script and seeing so many of the similarities, I was shaking my head while I was reading the script in the table read, and the producer afterwards, Judith, came up to me and said, "I saw you shaking your head," like she was worried that I didn't like it or something. And I said, "No, I said it just moved me so much because, I mean, that was a really, really special time in my life, and it completely changed my life. That movie, I mean, there wasn't a place on the earth that I could go that I wasn't mobbed after that movie." So it did. It brought back a lot of memories.
Well, let's talk about things now. You're an accomplished screenwriter, producer, an inventor of all things. Tell us about your invention.
I invented a fishing lure. I'm a mad fisherman, and I just invented this fishing lure. So it's just, you know, it's cool to have a patent, but that's all. It was just, I just wanted to catch more fish. So I did.
I was going to be a wise guy and say, "Wow, you invented the banjo minnow? That's
incredible."
No. That wasn't
mine
the
works,
case. I understand
mine
that.
Works better.
Tell us about your new screenplay.
Well, I'm working on some things right now. I just finished a picture that I was in with a long time gone with Virginia Madsen. I worked with Rosanna Arquette on a picture, and now I'm working on a project that hopefully we'll be shooting in North Carolina here in the next couple of months, a kids movie. So, you know, I've got a lot of stuff going on. I just am recovering from some back surgery. So, you know, yeah, it sucks getting older, but I'm feeling great and things are great. My son's married. I just don't know where all this time is going. And I can't wait to see this Blue Lagoon, The Awakening tomorrow. Tomorrow night, Saturday night, 8 to 10 on Lifetime. Got to say it, but I'm looking forward to seeing it
job.
Myself.
Okay, hold on a second. But you did it better anyway, so I'm glad you did it. But anyway, everyone wants to know, have you ever been to Buffalo/Niagara Falls?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I haven't actually stood there. My dad, when we were younger, used to fly, and we flew over it. So I flew over it, but I haven't actually been there. So that's one of the places I definitely want to go.
Well, as the unofficial ambassador to the Buffalo Chicken Wing, I have to tell you, when we have to invite you to Buffalo, we're going to take you to the Anchor Bar. Whenever you're anywhere near Buffalo, Niagara Falls, you're going to the Anchor Bar, and we're going to treat you to original chicken wings that were invented right here.
Okay, I'll take you up on that.
All right, sounds
I'll
good.
I'll take you up on that.
Everybody, it's Blue Lagoon, The Awakening debuts tomorrow, June 16th at 8 p.m. on the Lifetime Network. Christopher, thank you for joining us. We're delighted. You have fans here in Buffalo, just so you know.
Don, you're the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.